Hello everyone, Muro Sonero here. Welcome back for the Budokai 4 tier list. This is as of version 0.5.7, the version you've guys been looking and cheering for more than a month daily. Every character went through this challenge, first to 10 against Cooler, who managed to come up on top, and we moved on. And yeah, man, we have this difficult task of ranking all of these beautiful characters into the tier lists. And before we start, I must say that I am very, very happy to have such a beautiful community. And you guys are the best, for sure. The level of the dedication that you have for this small project of mine that's been going on for years of sharing the joy of Budokai, I really appreciate it. So thanks a lot, guys. And I don't want to make you wait anymore. I want to show you something really nice. I've made this Excel spreadsheet where I compiled some interesting stats. And as you can see, this first spreadsheet is for the wins. Every character has been compiled. And as you can see, some of them haven't reached 10 wins. These are the characters that failed. I think we can see it better in this other screen that we have. The losses. More characters than not managed to win the first 10, but some of them sadly couldn't make it. I think I can show you guys in terms of distribution. It looks like a 3/4 of the cast that managed to actually win the first 10 and a fourth that couldn't do it. It's a combination of things, you know. It's me, the player. I have to rise up to the occasion and win. But at the same time, innate character strength can do wonders, you know. So I'm just gonna put you guys on to something that I think is a bit more telling. This is a win-loss differential graph that I made. So you have the total amount of wins minus the amount of losses. And the scores vary a lot. The median, that's the statistic that gives you what 50% of the cast did, at least like that mark, that median of 3 that I'm showing you guys. Is representing the mark at which 50% of the cast did better or worse. I think it's a bit more telling than the average. So 50% of the cast did better than 3 and 50% of the cast did worse than 3. And yeah, I'm just gonna go ahead and start ordering the tier list according to this result page, and then we'll see. We'll see. So first character, let's start from the bottom up. We have, sadly, 16 that managed to just break with minus 7. So minus 7, it's really bad. He took 10 L's and only won 3. Oof. That gives him the worst place in the tier list. I'm just gonna give you some visibility. As you can see, we have the top tier, the high tier, the mid tier, the low tier, and the bottom tier. This place is the place where the characters that did the worst go, and I think 16, sadly, he has stuff, but I couldn't make use of it, and Cooler wrecked us, man. You gotta go back and watch. So 16 is the worst character. After that, it's Nappa with a score of minus 5, I believe. Minus 5. It's not a very beautiful score. Not at all. The poor guy. He managed to do a pretty cool thing, actually. I'm gonna put him just above 16, still in the bottom tier, but I want to come back and show you guys something. I want to come back and show you guys another part of the graph. It's actually in another page. I don't think you can see it well, but this is the win streak graph. And as for the win streak graph, we can see that 16 had a pitiful 1 maximal win streak value, but Napa has actually a win streak of 3. It's not that bad. It's actually a pretty good win streak. So if we go back to Napa, he might be worse than 16, but how much worse, you know? I think he's still in bottom tier, but I think that also marks like the beginning of the end of the bottom tier. Like the next characters that we got in the results, right? They are the androids. So as you can see, 17 and 18, the brothers, the twins, neck and neck with absolutely disgusting scores of -4. Better than the two before, but really not that good. And yeah, I think with -4, you're still kind of deep in the red. You gotta go in bottom tier. There's no saving you. But no, it's an interesting thinking process, you know? Who's better between those two? Who's better between those two? If we go by the win streaks, I'm curious. I want to go and check. So if we go by the win streaks, I believe that 18 and 17 did as good as each other with a maximal of 2. They couldn't do more than 2 of win streaks. Kind of sucks, but yeah. So we're not making too much differentiation between the two. In terms of personal taste, I guess I would give it up to the 17 more because of that absolutely insane K that he has. His K starter is beautiful, long range, dangerous. I think he has that over his sister. But I prefer the overall flow and look of the sister. But in terms of pure performance, I think he's more dangerous. So let's go back to our result. The spreadsheet that we had that did the difference between the amount of win accumulated and losses. Next one on the list is 18's husband, Goku's best friend, Krillin. Krillin, Kid Goku, and Tien, all of them three had the same score of -3. It's a shame. It really is. They managed to rack up 7 wins, but yeah, man, they still lost 10. So between them, let's see in the win streak screen who managed to outdo each other, right? So Tien is the worst. He has only 2. And then Kid Goku, where is he? Kid Goku has a huge win streak of 5. It's like I finally woke up and understood how he played. And Krillin has a win streak of 4. And I believe it's pretty representative. So I guess I'll put them in that specific order. Let's see. Where are you guys? Tien. Is it the start of the low tier? I think so. I think so. At least by the results, they did much better. So, Tien, our boy Krillin, and Kid Goku. There we go. It was a bit difficult to put him into place. It's maybe something I might change in the future, but for now, it kind of looks good. if we go back to our result spreadsheet. The next one is Cooler with a minus 2 score. Cooler and Broly with a minus 1 score. If we go and see the win streaks, in terms of win streak, Cooler did not too good with only 3. And Broly did the same with only 3. But at least Broly managed to get and rack up more wins. So that counts for something, and we will reflect it in their placement. Cooler, you'll go above Goku. And Broly, you'll go above all of them in the low tier. And now we enter the interesting part. The winners part. We enter the green zone. With all the characters that managed to have a positive score of 1. So plus 1, we have Raditz, we have Kid Buu, Bardock, Omega Shenron, Janemba. All of those managed to win 10-9. Super close. Broly could have been one of them, right? But it is what it is. You guys can go back and watch the set. But now, okay, we know they're in the green zone, right? And they deserve to go into mid-tier. Let's start with that. So let's remove this and put them into the mid-tier. So we have Bardock, Raditz. Where's Raditz? We have Janemba and Omega. These 4. Crazy, right? To see such a powerful character in mid-tier. But the scores are what they are. So let's go back and see the win streaks. So in terms of win streaks, it seems like Omega did better? Nah, Omega did bad. Omega only has 2. 2 of win streak. So he might even be the worst in terms of counting like that. Omega did only 2. Janemba managed to do incredible 6. Look at that. That's crazy. And Raditz managed to do 6 as well. So this is crazy. What about Bardock? Can you see him? He's at 5. So I guess in terms of order, we would have to switch them up to represent that. So let's give you bit more visibility. These 2 have the same win streak, better than Bardock and much better than Omega. So it looks like that for this part at least. Now we'll continue with some more in the green, a bit more green though. Let's go back to the results. And this win-loss differential, we can see that the next one is alone. He's by himself. It's Dabura. Dabura, man. Dabura managed to do a bit better with a differential of 2. Plus 2 for Dabura. What about his win streak, though? Dabura's win streak was a win streak of 4. Which is decent. It's a good one. Let's go back and place Dabura up there, above Raditz. Next ones, because they tied. Who might they be? We have Piccolo, Cell, Super Buu, Gohan, Majin Vegeta, and GT Vegeta with plus 3. All of them are equal in terms of win-loss differential. But what about the win streaks? In terms of win streaks, it seems like Where is he? Piccolo. Managed only three. Let's see. Where is he? GT Vegeta. Impressive five. And Majin Vegeta. Incredible six. That's some crazy win streak. And Cell, seven win streak. The best one that we've seen yet. So let's go back to our result and put everybody there. So Piccolo at the bottom. Let's see. Piccolo. And then we had Cell that had a superb win streak. Much better. Majin Vegeta that also had a superb win streak. Actually, the mid tier is quite stacked now. I don't know if we should move into high tier. Maybe just after them. The plus three, they're still mid tiers. So we'll wait. Let's go back to the XL. My memory is not too good. We had Super Buu, Gohan, Majin Vegeta, and GT Vegeta. So, Super Buu, Gohan, the adult one, Majin Vegeta, and GT Vegeta. And now I have to see. I have to see. We saw that Cell had a superb win streak. Cell had a superb win streak of seven. I think he's qualified to stay up there. Majin Vegeta had six. And Super Buu had also six. So I think they deserve to be neck and neck. Majin, Super Buu. I felt better using Super Buu, to be honest. I would put him a bit more higher up. And then GT Vegeta with five. And Gohan, where's Gohan? Gohan is pretty low with four. So yeah, I think it's pretty representative right now. It's good. They've been ordered. Very, very surprising for me, at least when you ask me, where did you think that a character such as GT Vegeta would have went? Man, I would have been, oh man, this is one of the top tiers, you know? But in terms of performance in that first to 10, you can go and watch that set. It was not too good, man. I was not playing too well. So this is how it's looking right now. It's looking pretty good and surprising, to be honest. But the surprises are not done yet. Let's see what we have next. Let's go back and we can see that the next category of characters is the characters that managed to rack up plus 5. And we got Super 17, Vegeta, Piccolo Daimao, Future Gohan, and that's it. That's these four, right? So let's go and place them on the tier list. Super 17, Future Gohan. Do we have him? I guess we can identify Future and Adult this way with the gi. The one that has the orange gi is Future Gohan. And the one that has the purple gi is Adult Gohan. So we have Future Gohan, 17, Piccolo Daimao. And, man, my memory is bad. Let's see. Vegeta. Vegeta was the one that was missing. And let's go straight into the win streaks. So in terms of win streaks, I'm going to place him right here. We can see Super 17 had an amazing 8-win streak. That's huge. One of the best in the whole series. If we go and look for descending, right? Because nobody there is, it's not the right characters. We have to look down from 17. We get Future Gohan next with a 5-win streak. Very decent. We keep going down and we have Vegeta, who also has 5. We keep going down and we have Piccolo Daimao with 4. So if I come back with, let's see, our tier list, I think it's pretty representative, but between Future Gohan and Vegeta, which one did I find stronger? It's a rough one. It is really, really rough. I guess I would put Vegeta a bit higher than Future Gohan, and I would do that mostly because of the unscaled damage that he has. It's absolutely insane to have such a tool. And yeah, overall, both of them have excellent kits, but I would put him a bit better than Future Gohan. Let's go, man. We still have some more characters to go through. And it's, I don't know if it's gonna be a big jump from the +5 that we had. Right afterwards, we have the +6. So we have Baby, we have Teen Gohan, Oob. These are the +6 characters. So a trio, Baby, Teen Gohan, and Oob. Let's see where they are in this tier list maker. Baby, Teen Gohan, and Oob. But now we gotta look at the win streaks. How well did they do? So, if I'm not mistaken, Teen Gohan had an amazing 6-win streak. It's very impressive, but if you saw the set with Super Saiyan 2, Soaring Dragon Strike, and his real-time ultimate, man, menace. And then we have who between Baby and Oob? Let me see. Oob with a +4 and Baby with a +4. So they're tied. Okay, it gives us a bit of leeway to be able to really choose. This guy, superior with the win streak at least, if we determine it like that. And in terms of both of them, Baby, we had a very, very good time with him. Especially against the CPU that doesn't know how to deal with some problematic strings, but I had transformations in the bag that I didn't know I could use. This character can hit a lot harder and become a much better version of himself, so. But Oob is so flexible, man. He has strings for days. It's like, it's night and day, the combo expressiveness that I have as Oob versus as Baby. But in terms of strength, I would give it, I don't know, it feels very weird because you got a character that can play simple and very effective, and a character that could do that, but it's too tempting to go and do whatever you want, you know. He's like a free canvas for an artist, a painter. I guess I would put him, because I have to account for his transformations that I didn't use. But I don't know. I don't know. I felt like in terms of overall score, I was a bit unlucky, and Oob should have done a better score. So I'll put him above, just for that reason, the feeling that he gave me during that set. We move to the next tier, I believe. Or no, not yet. Not yet. We stay in high tier, but we have the plus sevens. We have Dr. Gero, Goku, Gotenks, and Trunks. That's crazy. If you told me that Dr. Gero would be in the same tier as my man Goku, as my man Trunks, did you see how strong Trunks is in B4? If you haven't, go check the set. He's a menace. And Gotenks, yeah, Gotenks, you're like, okay, maybe I don't know, but he has Super Saiyan 3. You're like, man, Super Saiyan 3 versus a Cell Saga enemy like Gero, you know? But I was surprised. Gero is insane, especially against the CPU. But even outside that, I think he can do pretty well. So we'll go and look at the actual stats. We'll go and look at the actual win streaks to determine how good they did, right? So let's start with the top. What do we have? Dr. Gero with a massive plus 8 win streak. 8 in a row. The madman. And then we have to look for either Trunks or Goku or Gotenks. So I can see Trunks with a 5 win streak. I can see Gotenks with a 5 win streak. And then I can see Goku with a 4 win streak. So if we go back to our tier list, this is going to be crazy. This man goes up top. This man, the main man, Goku, my main, has to drop down and let his place to these two. And if I had to say, I think Trunks is a much more dangerous character than Gotenks. I think Trunks is one of the best characters in the game, and by a wide margin. Like, this is a dangerous character. He's very fun to play and very effective. And Goku, you guys saw me style on him, but yeah, we took too many L's, sadly. Gotenks, wow, Victory Cannon, Super Saiyan 3. He even has Galactic Donut, and I haven't used it. And he's small, so a lot of hits go over his head. Natural advantage. And yeah, man, I think it's the end for the high tier. I think we should move on to the top. Right now, we have a couple more characters. We'll see if they deserve to stay in the top. In terms of results, the next tier after Trunks and everybody is GT Goku, Gogeta, and Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta that are all plus 8 in terms of win-loss differential. So let's go and put them in the tier list. We have Gogeta. It's a bonus character, right? Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta and GT Goku. There you go. And I think that was it, right? Let's bring it back up. And Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta, but as we said, it's a bonus character. He was not finished. And even as an unfinished character, he did massive damage. He was insane. So yeah, let's see in terms of win streak between Gogeta, the Super Saiyan one, and GT Goku how it went. So, this is the funny part. If we look at the graph, right, I'm gonna push it to the right the most. You guys know it's the win streak, right? So I'm just gonna maybe de-zoom a little bit. Yeah, like that. Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta had a 10 win streak. That's crazy. The moment we found out that you can press forward E, it was over. But just below him, right, the unfinished character, we have GT Goku. GT Goku with a massive 8. That's a very, very nice win streak. And then we have to go down a bit to find Gogeta. Where is Gogeta? Gogeta. Is it me or he's not there? Am I crazy? He can't be that low. He is that low! Only 4 win streak. Man, I feel like Gogeta had his win streak broken at the worst place, you know? Where he couldn't build it back up. So, yeah, it's pretty clear between the two. GT Goku takes it. And we move. We move to the last few characters. I think I forgot somebody, no? Think we did. We forgot Kid Buu, man. Kid Buu was in the tier with Raditz, Bardock, and everybody. Sorry, guys, man. I'm really sorry. He's at plus one. And what's his win streak? Kid Buu. Kid Buu, Kid Buu. He had a plus five win streak. Raditz was at plus six. So, yeah. He goes naturally just below Raditz. And it feels very unfair to put him that low, but yeah, I wasn't doing too well. I really wasn't doing too well. So, yeah. If we go back to the tier list, sorry guys, I got distracted by the huge miss that we had for Kid Buu. Next up, after GT Goku and Gogeta, we had Vegito and Frieza. Vegito and Frieza are tied at plus 9 in terms of win-loss ratio. We're at the cream of the crop right now, the very best. And if we go in terms of win streak, I believe that Frieza and Vegito both had a 7 win streak. So this is, you can't go any closer than that. The two of them are immensely powerful. But in the end, if you want to know how I feel like Frieza is better. I said it. I feel like Frieza is better because as much as Vegito is a dangerous, very, very dangerous character, Frieza has so many transformations, man. It's now he's by far, I think, the character with the most because before he was tied with Goku, Goku had, so count with me, Kaioken, Super Saiyan, Super Saiyan 2. Super Saiyan 3 and Super Saiyan 4. He had 5 transformations. But now, Frieza, actually, now Goku has lost Super Saiyan 4. It's only for GT Goku. So he's down in terms of transformation to 4. But Frieza, he still has second form, third form, the final form. And the, what's it called? The maximum power one. So that's 4. And suddenly he becomes like tied for most transformations in the game, you know? I think I counted right? So he has the tall one, the tall dude, that spear-headed not spearheaded, that had like a, you know, a horn that went through Krillin, the poor guy. The form after that that looked like a xenomorph from Alien that shot Piccolo like crazy. And then the final form that we love, you know, the classic purple guy that we're looking at right now. And then the max power one, 100% max power. So yeah, I think the count is right, but that advantage that he has of if you press on him, he transforms and guard breaks you. Or if you do anything instead of blocking, you know, you get guard broken, or he can iframe through anything that you shoot at him, maybe an ult, he transforms and rushes you in. Transform is so good. It's been nerfed, but it's still really, really good. And in terms of overall strings, man, and what a grab. Combo grab sets up for a juggle. So many cancels. Big damage. Big damage by Frieza, especially when he gets his transformations, you know. We still have Yamcha, but Yamcha is not ready yet. So I cannot pronounce myself. This is how the tier list is looking like. I believe that it is a bit top heavy. As you can see, most of the cast is up there. It's not down. But at the same time, I wanted a differentiator between the guys that won their first to 10 and the guys that lost. So everything below mid-tier lost the first to 10. Some of these guys were really close, but still. Mid-tier and up, they won the first to 10. And they had sometimes massive win streaks that managed to put them a bit over the edge over another. And yeah, man, I think it's looking pretty good, man. I really like the final look of it. I don't know for you guys, but yeah, we might be able to, look at a final part of my spreadsheet that I called the lose streak part. So this is a losing streak graph. And inside, as you can see, we might be able to. We might be able to get some mileage out of it. So, who lost the less, right? We have Vegeta that really only lost one losing streak. He never went down a lot, like game after game losing. Vegeta was one of the most solid ones. Baby, Gero, Goku, Gotenks, GT Goku, Gogeta, Vegito, Frieza, Piccolo, Daimao. All of these characters, I couldn't lose more than one at a time. I think it says a lot about them. But now, let's see. Like, if we take these, the characters that were pretty solid, right? And see here, what do we have? For example, Vegeta, the regular Vegeta. Between him, Future Gohan, and Piccolo Daimao, if we bring it back, we can see that he's in the same as Piccolo Daimao. So I think it says a bit that they're close. It's good. But compared to Future Gohan lost three in a row. Future Gohan lost three in a row, so I guess he's a bit harder to get your hands really acclimated, you know, your brain, you wrap around your head around the guy. You can see it as that also. The lose streak could be how difficult are they to wrap your head around? And I think it says a pretty good story. If you look at Nappa, the way we started the first few games, it was bad. It was really bad. We were not playing Nappa right at all, at all. But then suddenly, We started to play. And somehow, Nappa, who had the worst losing streak, is not the worst character. He's above 16. Not by much, but he's still above him. And then we have Majin Vegeta. Majin Vegeta, who is mid-tier and pretty up there, as you can see. Pretty up there. But had a massive losing streak. Massive. Of, I think, six in a row. Wow. Six in a row. Because my brain was too used to the other Vegetas, and he plays quite a bit differently. What about the rest? It's surprising to see Cell in there. It really is. He's such a, like, most of these characters that have a four losing streak, it's a bit of an anomaly. It's maybe a bad day on my part or something like that. Bad day at the office. Some of them should have done better, but still, it says something, you know? Maybe I'm trying to play them B3 and it doesn't work. You gotta play them really the new way that they've been made. But yeah, I hope that you find this exercise interesting. We finally have our tier list right now. It's looking really, really good. And if we go from top to bottom this time, we have Frieza, Vegito, GT Goku, and Gogeta as the current top tiers for Budokai 4. And then right after that, we have the high tiers with Dr. Gero, Trunks, and I believe that these two have proven that they can have a word with the top tiers. Like they, when you're solid, they can go to the top. They have that ability. So the high tiers, let's continue with Gotenks, Goku, Teen Gohan, Ub, Baby, Super 17, Vegeta, Future Gohan, Piccolo Daimao. Very solid lineup for the high tier. Like, if you look at this, you have a pretty good variety of play styles also. You have someone like Piccolo Daimao with huge range, higher defense than usual. The guy can survive longer simply because he has, like I said, a higher defense percent than most characters, and especially Piccolo himself. But since he can't transform, he doesn't have as much of a dangerous damage output. But you'd be surprised with some of his moves that hurt quite a bit. And you have characters that really want to go in and stay in, like Teen Gohan, Ub. Ub, you could decide also to lame people out, man, with that ki cannon. It's pretty fast, invisible, can be pretty good. Who also can play pretty lame? Man, I think Super 17 is such a crazy designed character. He plays a different game. Do not shoot anything in his way. Because the moment he absorbs it, you guys seen it. You guys seen it. The moment he absorbs it, it's over, bro. It's over. So yeah, you got a pretty good variety here, and you have Sword Trunks, man. Woo! Juggles for days. If you guys know how to RBD, literally, you cannot, like, you can have easy ground infinites. He has so many tools. And yeah, you know, I have a special soft spot for Goku. What a character. Then we go to the mid tiers. The mid tiers that also managed to be very good to win the first 10. We got Cell, Super Buu, Majin Vegeta, GT Vegeta, Adult Gohan, Piccolo, Dabura, Raditz, Kid Buu, Janemba, Bardock, and Shenron. Sin Shenron, because he has to transform to get to Omega. And once he transforms, he gets access to a move that you can't teleport. He's a dangerous guy, bro. And the Dragon Thunder, it's so underexplored and utilized. You can use it as extra damage. You can use it as a pressure tool. You can use it as an anti-TC. And we're far from maximizing the potential that it has. It's really a sick and unique tool that he has at his disposition. Super Buu, changing his absorb mechanic for transformations, this guy is a problem. He's a problem. He's very, very strong. Cell, he's infinite will Cell, who is very good. But you add to that the B3 things that made him crazy, crazy difficult to deal with. You should have the best character, right? But for some reason, the results speak otherwise. I couldn't show the true Cell potential either. It's a lot of that tier list. All of these characters have not been mastered and shown their true potential. But we've shown how easy they are to pick up and how dangerous they can be, even with little to no knowledge. So yeah, let's continue with Majin Vegeta, GT Vegeta. This guy is gonna get nerfed. Like, he has mid-tier result right now, but as I said, you go Super Saiyan 4, that's a win condition. You can't lose. You go Super Saiyan 4, you hit one random hit into fully charged Shining Rage. My guy, the health bars are dropping so fast, it's crazy. He's a menace. Gohan, with his Soaring Dragon Strike, you guys know how it is. Unskilled damage. And now he has a real-time ultimate with Masenko. Really good one at that. I really like the redesign. He might get a bit more buffs. I don't know. But he feels pretty good right now. Piccolo. Yeah, man. Same as Piccolo Daimao, but even more powerful in attack. And I think that the experience I got with him got me a better result with the other guy. So they should be very close, but as you can see, he's down here and the other one is up there. Dabura, what a pleasure to play. You can do everything you want with this character. He's amazing. I love him. The sword swings, the spear strikes that he has, you stab people almost across the map. And you can cancel it to do some juggles. And then you can dash in and combo and ground reset them. He's insane. Raditz. Raditz has changed profoundly and in very important ways and in very beneficial ways for him. And if you manage to understand how to use his Black Monday, I think, or something like that, the one that they ported from Burst Limit that he strikes with his kicks. That stuff hurts. Man, it's strong. Fully charged. Woof. Kid Buu. Menace. Ki battery. You generate so much ki with this guy. And you use it because he has the Assault Rain that can do crazy setups. You have some just quick damage that you can do with the ball, right? Or the Kamehameha. I think he still has one of the fastest beams. I don't know, I have to replay him to double check, but what a character. And the Ki Blast game. Woo! You wanna be really careful against him, not to take some counter hit Ki Blast out of nowhere. Cause he shoots them fast and Yeah, he moves very, very well. One of the best sidesteps in the game. Smalls, a lot of hits go over his head. Yeah, I love the guy. Janemba, a bit broken. A bit broken. Some things don't work properly, but he's gonna get fixed. I like the intention that went with him, giving him what he has. I think his back special, the Rakasha's Claw, I think it's really good, but it feels a bit weird to use. Need more work, to be really frank with you guys. Bardock can turn Super Saiyan now, and he has access to fully charged Hit Phalanx mid combo. If you get hit by that, say goodbye to your health bar. It's a bit like GT Vegeta's Shining Rage. Wow. Or Raditz, right? Some characters have that thing about them. And Hit Phalanx for this guy, whoa. It's something else. Omega, we spoke a lot about him. Broly, what a shame. We were so close. We were so close. Oh. He has everything. He has everything you could ask for. He's really excellent. I love the guy. But the result didn't show up, you know. Cooler? It was tough, man. Like he doesn't play like I was expecting. So it was rough trying to adapt to his moveset and make it work. But the more we played, the more we tried. I found a couple things and there's a lot more to find. I think he's a very, very powerful and dangerous pick. And the things that I didn't show myself with him, you guys saw in the first to 10 against all these dudes. He was doing some crazy stuff sometimes. You were like, whoa, that's a cool kit that he has. Kid Goku, awesome dude. Power pull combos for days, slam you into the ground to make you bounce. He's great. And they gave him an easier unskilled infinite with rock, paper, scissors. Yeah, I like him. Krillin and Tien, man, these guys play so nice. I love to play with these guys. Their moveset is cool, fluid. My guy is sliding everywhere. And this guy is doing these weird, like, I don't know how to describe them, like these strikes, kind of like Neji from Naruto, pointing at your chakra points. Pop, up, pop, up. He's cool, man. I love the guy, but he has a problem with with Kikoho, bro. What a problem. It misses from range zero, it misses from across the map. You're like, bro, it's a wall of projectile light, you know, it should hit, and it's a big problem. Yeah, I think he needs a bit of fixing, but promising. The androids, so stylish, had a horrible time with them in terms of result, but great time in terms of pleasure to play. Nappa. The more I see about him, the crazier he seems. And as I said, PvP Nappa is crazy good compared to versus CPU, where they tech everything, right? You throw any throws, grab, they tech it online, bro, or even offline against a normal dude. If you counter hit grab someone, they're not teching, they're gonna get hit. And if they get hit, whoa, this guy goes to town. 16. Man, 16, he has something really funny that I wish I could show you guys. When you're at max key and you press, I think you gotta press E plus G, I'm not sure, don't quote me on that. He uses all the key to grab you, and if he does, he explodes himself and everybody dies. And you actually, I think you win by like one health point, but they die, right? So And if you miss, right, you get fatigued and you're at zero health. So people can instantly guaranteed kill you, but it's a very high risk, high reward thing. I really like it. Shoulder charge is pretty cool. Reminds me of Broly's shoulder press. I don't know how it's called. Yeah. What a game, what a game. We're not even version 1.0. We're far from version 1.0. And look at all these characters, look at all these changes, new moves. Don't you love it? I want you guys to give a big shout out to the dev team, Dopiera and Nim, that are behind it. And a big shout out to the beta testers that keep feeding them with some quality feedback to be able to correct some bugs, adjust some things for the characters. And yeah, try it out. Try it out. Link in the description, link in the comment section. I'm gonna pin it. You guys have to get on that before. For the love of Budokai, man. They don't make them like this anymore. So go ahead, man. Have some fun. Have some fun. I hope that you guys enjoyed it. And yeah. See you soon. Take care. Bye bye.